धन्यवाद श्री ए राजा
सर थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर गिविंग दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू कमेंड अपॉन द बिल एंड डेफिनेटली आई विल नॉट पुश यू टू रिंग योर बिल सर व्हेन द बिल इज बीइंग मूव्ड फॉर कंसिडरेशन I have, it has come to my mind that World Bank report which rating the 109 countries in carrying of the business, in carrying of the business, an assessment that has been done by the World Bank where the India has been rated at 77, ranked at 77. Sir, some of the factors which culminated the World Bank report are starting business, enforcing contracts, paying taxes, resolving insolvency, and other factors. Sir, what is the rate of India in all these factors? Starting of business, 137, enforcing contract, 163.
World Bank report of which year?
Which one?
World Bank report of?
Last current year, last financial year. Sir, paying taxes, 121. Resolving insolvency 108. Sir, I hope with good intention the minister has come up with files of this bill. The amendments and the sections were intended to satisfy the requirements to fulfill the need of the to reach the exalted position of the World Bank rating in future. Sir, I think this all these parameters which have been enhanced in the World Bank must be kept in the mind of the government. Through this amendment, we hope jointly let us fulfill the World Bank factors to be achieved. Sir, I have carefully perused the bill. I can understand the intention of the government. I hope positively that the intention has to be achieved in a perspective manner. I think that two things are contemplated in the bill. Maybe correct or not, madam, correct me. Ease of the doing business by the companies and the to curb the shelf companies. These are all the prime elements you wanted to address besides all issues. So the intention of the government is good. I am having little bit not apprehension, some small reservations how we are going to achieve it, because honorable minister is well fond of Tamil couplets or Tamil literature. The end which has been cited in the bill is okay, yes, we have to achieve, but what about the means? Because Tamil literature always says that the end is not important, more important is how to reach the means. Indral pasigalambal ayilum seyerka sandror palikum vinai, that is the couplet, it is known to the honorable minister. I am worrying about the how we are going to reach the means. Sir, I recall my memories when the 2013 the bill was introduced in the parliament. I think that it was referred to the finance committee, which recommended the corporate social responsibility fund. I will come to later. Thereafter, a committee was set up under the secretaryship, chairman of the secretaryship. That committee recommended more than 25 or 50 recommendations, if it is correct. Out of the recommendations, I think that this bill has been culminated. The motto of the bill, maybe I say, decarb the cell companies and decarb the NCLT. Sir, as far as the cell companies are concerned, yes, it has been well drafted in the bill that you want. Your intention is very clear, but very good provisions, no doubt. But still, I am having one small doubt. Sir, by reading 10A, that is insertion of section 10A, an amendment of section 12, that is 4(9). And in the 10-year one, declaration is filed by the director within the period of 180 days, the date of incorporation of the company in such form, and verified in such a manner as may be, so-and-so has paid the value of shares agreed to be taken by him. That is the self-declaration. Then coming to the section 12, the Principal Act, you are adding one more section, that if the registrar has reasonable cause to believe that the company is not carrying any business. Sir, reasonable clause is a little bit tricky word. The intention of the minister may be good. I am not doubting the intention of the government. But when we are drafting the law, reasonable cause to believe that the company is not carrying on any business or operations, that too by registrar. Sir, why you are giving all powers to individual man? Already there is excessive delegation of power in the bill, I will come to later if time permits. But my only suggestion is, when you are giving absolute and total power to the registrar, a single man who is sitting across the country somewhere else, Chennai or Bombay or Hyderabad, how he is going to exercise his power? That is very important. That is why I may suggest, at least in the future, instead of registrar, there must be somebody has to have a collective decision. The decision must be just and fair. Sir, coming to the other point, declock of NCLT. I feel there is an excessive delegation of power. More role by the government may lead to the arbitrary decision. I welcome the measures are taken to simplify the penal sections. As you introduce the in-house procedure mechanism, I welcome the in-house procedure mechanism. Still, there is also apprehension that remedial measures should be taken. Sir, finally, penalty has been viewed as a means to deter the companies violating law. But the fivefold increase cannot be justified. Please look into. Finally, CSR fund. If the fund is not spent, you want to create a special account or yet another account to fulfill your dream. But why you are creating more and more accounts instead of opening the more account? Simply I suggest all the funds can be shifted to the Prime Minister's Relief Fund, where the big demand is there. It may be considered. With this, let's conclude. Thank you.
இந்த வீடியோ உங்களுக்கு பிடிச்சிருந்தா ப்ளீஸ் லைக் அண்ட் ஷேர் பண்ணுங்க. மறக்காம எங்க சேனலை சப்ஸ்கிரைபும் பண்ணுங்க.